Welcome to the second installment of How Not to Suck at Left 4 Dead. This is Lesson 2 on Pounces. Today I'm going to be showing you not only Pounces, but how to actually practice them before you take it in-game. So first off, I'm going to actually explain how to set up a game to be able to practice this. Right up on your screen, I'm going to throw all the commands you need and explain in order what to do. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is start a lobby and go infected. Invite a buddy to get on Survivor to help you out. Now go ahead and host the game locally, and you just start stop. It'll give you the option. When you're in there, go ahead and in console type sv_cheats1. That'll enable the following codes. Director stop in console, that'll get rid of all the zombies. And kick all the other bots, kick Zoe, Lewis, whoever's not your friend. Get them out of there. Go ahead, type God 1. That's going to make you invincible. And also, this helps out a lot. Type these commands exactly as you see here. If you press H, it'll spawn you as a hunter at any time. And N, for no clip, will just give you faster navigation throughout the map and allow you to get off your buddy that you pounced. So let's jump right into trajectory. A good exercise for this is to just pop your spray in the ground right there and, you know, pounce on it. See if you could land directly on it. If you can't, you need some more work. Just keep trying until you get the trajectory down. It's just like, you know, throwing a football. You gotta get it down. Also, in learning your trajectory, you also have to learn your limits. You need to know when, you know, a pounce is too far to make. So go ahead, you could learn that on your own time, and get your buddy in there and just start practicing pounces. If you're in a game, you know, I did it when I was new too, you're on top of something and you just lob a pounce up there, you know it's not gonna hit. Just go in game, practice. You got all the commands now. You need here I'm going to demonstrate the most basic of pounces. It's just the regular wall jump. What you're gonna do is walk right up to a wall, crouch, and pounce into it. As immediately after you hit that wall, you turn 180 degrees and just click your mouse again, and you'll bounce into the next wall, and you can just keep doing it. Here's a good place to practice it. Alright, so after you've mastered trajectory and applied the basic wall jump to get where you need to be, another tip I can give you is not to perch up on the side of a building when you make the pounce. I know in the example here you don't see the outline, but usually you'll see the survivor's outline. If you back up just a little bit and stay out of view, there's going to be less of a chance you'll get dodged or shot out the sky or meleeed. Another tip I can give you is to crouch at the very last second, right before you pounce. When I was new, I just sat up there and crouched for 30 seconds before I, you know, went to miss my pounce. The less time they see you, less time they have to react to that pounce. Also, try to go in on a boom, you know, when somebody happens to be standing still in a corner. So remember, use those tips and you will get better pounces. To do a basic wall kick pounce, which is very beneficial and sneaky, just angle into a wall, and if it's on the left, press A, if it's on the right, press D, and aim into your target. Click as soon as you hit the wall, basic wall jump. Here's another example of when the basic wall kick could be used. As you see here, this first pounce gets scrubbed, and on the second attempt, you put that basic wall kick into effect, and you essentially come out with a high damage pounce. see, I'm aiming at my target on the right, but I'm hitting the one on the left. It's pretty basic, pretty simple, but it is probably the most useful thing you can know in pouncing. So, I'm aiming to the right, and when I get in air, I'm actually holding A and slowly bringing my mouse to the left. Okay, let's get this IM out of here. Alright. So, holding A, bringing the mouse to the left. Oh my god, what a curve. Now for the opposite way, I'm going to aim at my target on the left, right there. And once I get in air, I'm going to hold D and slowly torque that pounce over to the right with my mouse. Very important stuff. Vertical jumping is pretty straightforward. All you do is back up into a flat wall, crouch, and look straight up. As you're pouncing upwards, you're going to bring your crosshair or your aimer down just a little bit, even that angle out, and you can just keep clicking and pounce straight up. So all this stuff is cumulative. You pretty much just learn one skill and build upon it, and you can come up with better, more effective pounces. This wall kicking, it's really good. It's higher momentum. Your feet actually come straight down into the target rather than you flying like a Superman, just begging to get skeeted. You just gotta practice this stuff and perfect it, really, before you use it in game. As you can see right here, wall kick comes in really fast. Can't even get the skeet off. Just about out of time here, so I'm going to go ahead and put this into a two-part series, the next part being a more comprehensive look at wall strafing. Here's a little sexy pre-light to end the show, and I'll be back with part two. Thanks for watching.